Good morning, my dear children. Welcome to the science class. So, my dear children, how are you all? I hope you are fine and you are safe. Okay. So, on Friday, due to some problem, I can't able to send the notes. Okay. So, don't worry about that. I will send the notes today. Copy it in your notebook. Okay. Don't worry about that. I will send it today. Okay. Then, have you studied chapter 2? Yes, okay. I will send the question today. Write the answers in a paper. After that, take a snapshot and send to me. Okay, then if you have any doubt, please contact me before 7 o'clock, or else you can contact we can discuss it in the Zoom interaction class. Okay, so up to our previous class, we have completed our 4th chapter, right? So today we are entering into a new chapter. So take your textbook and take a pencil along with you. Okay, so we will learn the chapter today, new chapter today. So what is the topic of the chapter? Means weather and season. Okay, chapter 5, weather and seasons. Okay, so what is weather and what is season? How many seasons are there? 4 seasons are there, right? So we are going to learn about the weather and season. Okay, so take your textbook. I will mark the important line with a green marker here. Okay, so you can mark it in your textbook with a pencil. Okay, so first, weather. Okay, so weather means sometimes it is sunny, right? And sometimes it is cloudy, right? And some days it is rainy, and some days it is windy, right? Sometimes there will be a storm, right? Sometimes there will be a smooth wind blows. Right, so there will be change. One day, the day before yesterday, it is sunny, right? It is very hot, and yesterday it's rainy, right? And today it is a somewhat windy and cloudy, right? So there's a change. Okay, so weather means is a condition of the atmosphere at a particular place and time. Okay, it's a condition of the atmosphere. There is some condition of the atmosphere at a particular place and time. Okay, so it differs. Okay, how it is differs mean according to the temperature, humidity in the rain, sorry, in the air, rainfall, the wind speed and so on. Okay, so at a particular place, how the condition is there? Sometimes the temperature is high, it is sunny. Okay, sometimes there will be some humidity, the water level in the air is becoming increasing, it is rainy. Okay, according to the condition whether the place is, the weather changes. Okay, so factors. So what are the factors? Means amount of sunlight falling on the area, the amount of sunlight which falls on the area, then the geographic location of the area, which place, whether it is located in the north side or the south side. Okay, then air pressure in the area, then amount of water. Okay, amount of water in the atmosphere means in the air affect the weather. Okay, so this will affect the weather. If there is the amount of temperature is increased, it will be very sunny, right? So according to the changes in the atmosphere, the weather changes. Okay, it's not the season. Season means it takes some months to change, right? Summer season means we know that May, June, July, it's a summer season. Right, then winter season means it starts from October and it ends at January, February. Right, season means takes long time. Right, so weather means at a particular time, yesterday it is sunny and today it is rainy. Okay, the change in the atmosphere, the change in the condition in the atmosphere, it changes. That is weather. Okay, according to the condition, the temperature, or due to the humidity, or due to the wind, okay, it changes. Okay, for a particular day or for a particular hours. Okay, morning it is very sunny and afternoon it there will be some cloudy and evening it will rain. Okay, so according to the condition in the atmosphere, the weather will change. Okay, so have you seen a sky turn dark and stormy? Okay, you might have seen that. Okay, the it is sunny, suddenly the clouds will come, it will darken and it will rain. Right, so the change in the temperature affect the weather. Okay, change in the temperature affect the weather in the particular place. Okay, so the temperature begins to rise after the sunrise and begins to fall at the sunset. Right, during sunrise the temperature is little bit decreasing, right? So after it after the sunrise it will get increases at 12 noon, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock the temperature is very high, right? And at 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock the temperature becomes decreasing. Okay, so totally the weather will depends upon the temperature. Okay, so different places have different temperatures, right? So we have some moderate temperature, and the place people who are living in the middle of the India like Rajasthan, Gujarat, they have a very high amount of temperature because it's a desert area, right? So the people who are living in the northern region, that Himalayas, then Simla, okay, that place Jammu and Kashmir, they have cold climates because it's a cold region, right? It's a cold cold region. Okay, so different places have different temperature. So the place which is located near the equator mean if you take that globe, okay, if you take that globe, middle there will be a line, right? One middle line is there, so that is the equator. Okay, so the place which is located near the equator is very 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 hot, okay, which is very hot. And the poles near the equator are hotter, while the place located on near the poles, okay, pole mean upper pole and below pole is there, which is very cool. Okay, pole is very cooler. Okay, this is because why the places near the equator is very hot means because the equator receive the vertical rays, direct rays of sunlight. Okay, well, comparing with the north and south pole, the equator region receives the vertical rays, direct rays of sunlight, but the north and south pole receives slanting rays. So only we are getting some little bit of sunlight, but in the desert the sun rays are very high because it is very hot, right? So but in our place it is somewhat little bit small, right? Little bit decreasing. Okay, little amount of sunrise only we are getting. Okay, the northern region, while comparing with us, northern region have very less amount of sunrise. Okay, so weather depend upon the so many factors. Okay, so what are the factors affect the weather? We will discuss it below. Okay, first one is sun, clouds, rain and wind. So what are the factors mean? Sun, clouds, rain and wind. So sun, without sun there will be no weather, right? Without sun there will be no weather. So sun heat the water on the earth, right? Sun will heat the water on the earth and this causes evaporation, right? So in the previous chapter also we have learned about the evaporation. The sun heat the water and it turns into water vapor, it evaporates, right? So this water vapor evaporates and reaches the cloud and it forms the clouds, and then from the cloud it again condenses and it causes rain, snow, fog and dew, right? So sun is responsible for all the process. Sun is responsible for rain, snow, fog and dew, right? So on the sunny days, okay, the sun shines brightly, right? On the sun sunny days the sun shines brightly and make the earth warm, right? So and we have a hot day, on that day it is very hot, right? So we will sweat and we may feel thirsty, and so clothes also will dry very faster, right? During sunny days we will feel very tired also. Sunny days means it is very hot and we will feel tired to work also, right? So this is one of the factor. Okay, sun is one of the factor which affect the weather changes. Okay, then second one, clouds. Okay, on during cloudy days it's not too hot or sunny because the clouds will hide the sun, right? So the sun rays will not fall on the earth. Okay, so the temperature are little bit cooler and some clouds will bring some rain. Okay, not heavy rain, little bit amount of rain. Okay, so cloudy days are cooler while comparing with the sunny days. Okay, clouds also affect the temperature. Sun also affect the weather, clouds also affect the weather. During cloudy days the cloud will close the hide the sun, and the cloud, some clouds will bring some amount of rainfall, and while comparing with the sunny days, the cloudy days are little bit cooler. Okay, then the next one is, and then when the sky is filled with the white fluffy clouds, okay, we like to see the clouds in the sky, right? When there is a white fluffy clouds, it is a bright day, Okay, if we see the clouds are very white and it looks like a snow, it's a bright day. Okay, when the sky is filled with a dark cloud, it is expected to be rain. Okay, if you see the white clouds, it is a bright day. If you see any dark clouds, it is expected to have a rain. Okay, so thus clouds also affect the weather. Okay, then wind. So what is wind? Moving air. Moving air is called wind. Okay, so when the wind blows gently, a small wind, we can say it's a gently wind, that is called breeze. Okay, when the wind blows gently, it is called breeze. At the time of 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, if you sit go outside of your house, a slow wind blows, right? So that is breeze. Okay, it's not too cooler, but it is little cooler, that is called breeze. Okay, so in the sunny days, sometimes in the sunny days we will feel a little breeze, gentle breeze. Okay, so when the wind that is breeze, if the wind flows in some of the heavy force, with some heavy force, we call it a storm. Okay, if the wind blows with a heavy wind, we call it as a storm. Right, if there is a heavy storm, it will uproot the huge trees, right? It will cut this, it will make the huge tree to fell down, and it causes lot of damages, right? So wind also affect the weather. Okay, in summer time, the hot wind blows, right? So that makes the weather hot, and in the winter season, cold wind blows, it makes the weather cooler. Okay, during cloudy days, a small breeze will flow, it will make little cooler. Okay, so wind also affect the weather changes. Okay, do you understand up to this much? Okay, the next one is rain. Okay, rain. And the next one is rain. Okay, so we know that how rain is formed, right? So the sun will come and it heat up the water, then the water vapor get into the clouds and it cool down and it changes into water, right? So that's only we are getting rain, bro. So we dark clouds will bring the rain, right? So the rain can pour down heavily or lightly, right? And the day before yesterday we have rain, right? It is little rain, it's light rain. Okay, heavily also it will fall down, lightly also it will fall down. Okay, so when the rain pour lightly, we call it as drizzle. Okay, when there is a little rain, we call it as drizzle. Okay, what is that called? Drizzle. Okay, if there is a heavy rainfall with heavy wind, that is called storm. Okay, along with the heavy wind, we call that heavy rain as a storm. Okay, do you understand up to this much? Okay. So these are the factors affecting the weather. Okay, so what are the factors? Sun, clouds, wind and rain. Okay, then the next one is important one, water cycle. Okay, water cycle. So water will change from one form to another, right? Water will change into solid and it will change into liquid, then it will change into gas, right? It can turn into any form, right? So during hot day, during sunny days, the water bodies in the lake, river, seas, ocean will get heat, right? Due to heavy sun rays, it will get heated, right? So this water will evaporate due to heating. If you boil the water, it will evaporate, right? Due to heating, the water will evaporate and it will change into the water vapor. Okay, this water vapor rises into the air. Okay, it is carried by the air and form the clouds. Okay, it is carried by the air and it form the clouds. Okay, if the clouds cool, they will fall down into the earth as rain. Okay, see, due to sun, the water is evaporated. See, the water is evaporated and it forms the cloud. Okay, then the clouds will cool down, it fell down as a rain. It's a continuous process. Okay, so then this rainwater, again it comes into the water body, it gets evaporated again, and this cycle continues. Okay, do you understand? So during hot day, during summer days, the water waters in the water body get evaporated and it carries by the water and it form the clouds. When the clouds will cool down, it fall down as a rain. Do you understand? Yes. Okay, then next one. So this is the continuous cycle. right? So where the water will evaporate, it will travel in the air, it will form, it then fall in the earth, then evaporate again. So that is called the water cycle. So water cycle is also controlled by sun. Okay, water cycle is also controlled by sun. So that only after summer days we are getting rainy days, right? So due to this water cycle only we are getting rainy days often. Okay, the next one is weather forecast. So what is weather forecast mean? We all having Android mobile with us, right? So in the Android mobile, in the wallpaper there's a place where is 32 degrees Celsius might expect to be rain today, or it is cloudy today, it is rainy today. A weather report is there, right? So weather forecasting is an information what will happen in our future days, or what will happen today evening. Okay, based on the information that is available now. Okay, so how we are weather forecast mean? They will study, they will assess the conditions such as temperature, humidity, wind. Okay, they will assess it. Okay, temperature, humidity, they will assess it, and they will finally make it into a atmospheric process. Okay, they will finally make it atmospheric process, and they will make a weather report of the today. Okay, so weather forecasters rely on computer data, satellite images, and their own observation to accurately forecast the weather. Okay, they will rely on the computer data, satellite images, or their own observation, and finally they will release their weather report. Okay, so weather forecasts are mostly helpful to the farmers, fishermen, pilots and sailors, right? So if there to be rain, the farmers will make that work for the rainy days. Then fishermen, they will not enter into the sea, they will not sail into the sea. Pilots also, they will not take off the airplanes. Then sailors also, they will not take off their boat, right? So there are ships, right? So weather forecast will help all of them. In our in my mobile also, every day there will be a weather forecast. It is expected to be rain today, or it is cloudy today. Okay, it's in my mobile wallpaper. You can check your mobile also, the weather forecast is there. Okay, so farmers which crop we can plant depending upon the weather. And fishermen, they need to know whether it could be a rainy day or clear day for fishing. Okay, then airlines, how they can fly their flights or not, or how's the weather condition. And sailors also, they will set out for the sail according to the weather condition. Okay, so this is enough today. We will learn the remaining portion in our next class. So I will send the notes today, copy it in your notebook. If you have any doubt, we will discuss in the Zoom interaction class, or we will discuss in our, you can call me or text me. Okay, so we will meet in our next class. Until, take care. Bye bye. Thank you.